I cannot prove it. You said, how can I follow a man who said kill and have a slave woman and other than that? And now I want to be consistent for the sake of argument, which you are misquoting the verse. Do you believe Moses to be a prophet of God?
Yeah, why are you suddenly moving on from the Quran?
No, I want to be consistent.
No,
the Bible, the Bible. No. And now, if, imagine now, let me explain to you. Lizzie, let me explain to you. Imagine I say, brother, I don't believe in you because you have...
Why are you talking about Moses,
sir? Can I speak now? Can I speak? I'll show you why. I'll show you why. I'm not a subject. If I take... Look. Now, can I speak, yeah? Imagine I tell this brother, I don't like you because you're wearing jumper. Don't walk with me. But bear in mind, he's walking with me and he's wearing jumper. Is that a contradiction?
Sir, what are you talking about?
Well, I'm talking that Moses killed his enemies. Moses had slaves, women and children. Moses, he raped women, but he was a prophet of God. Do you accept he's a prophet of God?
Sorry, I'm not talking about Moses.
Yeah, but you said Prophet Muhammad. That's what you said. You said you don't follow...
Moses is nobody.
Excuse me. You said you don't follow Prophet Muhammad.
Lizzie,
what I'm saying... Lizzie, you said...
Let's talk about Muhammad.
Listen. No. I'll show you that you are a hypocrite. You are a hypocrite. That you reject Prophet Muhammad, but you follow Moses, who killed his enemies, who had slaves, women, slave children, enslaved children, women. He killed women that were old, and he kept a young woman as a slave. But yet, you accept him as a prophet. Doesn't make any sense. That's a hypocrisy.
Lizzie,
any person who has a sound intellect. And now Prophet Muhammad.
The Bible doesn't teach me to follow Moses today,
hypocrisy.
Sir.
Let me go to the Bible.
Quran teaches you.
I want to go to the Bible.
Muhammad, do you have
let
an exalted standard
what the Bible
of character?
Says about Moses.
Now, why are we talking about Moses?
I'll tell
Moses
you why.
Is irrelevant.
I'll tell you why.
Muhammad,
because I'll tell you.
According to your
I'll tell you why.
You believe your exalted standard of character.
You're finished, Lizzie?
A friend, only if we're going to talk about Muhammad
today. I'll tell you why. And now, if you tell me you cannot follow Prophet Muhammad because of this and that, therefore you have to be consistent upon your criteria.
Okay, yeah,
okay? Because
yes.
No.
I can be consistent about
okay.
Muhammad,
so it's Moses, Prophet of God.
It's
Moses, Prophet of God.
No,
she's not listening.
Okay.
It's Moses, Prophet of God.
I told you I'm not talking about Moses.
But you said Prophet.
Because he's not
Lizzie.
A prophet for today, is he?
Okay, this
Muhammad
is a subject.
Is your prophet
it's a subject. That's a subject.
No,
it doesn't want to be.
Okay. Listen. Okay, listen. Let me deal with that. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Let's talk about Zainab. Surah 33.
Can I speak now?
Ayah 36.
Can I speak now? Can I speak now?
Okay, this is Zainab.
Okay, she was
the daughter of Muhammad's adopted son.
She's gonna let me speak.
And Muhammad lusted after her, didn't he? And so Zainab said, "Fine." His son said, "Fine. I'll get divorced, and then you can marry her."
Show me that in the Quran.
Is that what you would
show
like
me in
to
the Quran
to your wife?
Yeah, that's the Quran.
What you would that, like? Yeah. Is that like how you choose a
when
wife?
When you finish, I mean,
you've adopted somebody, they get married, and they actually, no, I fancy her now. I think I'll get married to her. This is your prophet for
you
today. Is that how you guys?
Can you tell
women?
Me the verse?
I really hope not.
Can you tell me the verse?
Yeah.
I want to show you this. She's a lying.
Muhammad,
the Quran said for Muhammad last.
33,
ayah
36 to 38. And then,
excuse me.
You can just go from wife to wife to wife. Surah 33, ayah 50 to 52. You can go from wife to wife to wife. It doesn't matter.
Excuse me.
You can have one night,
excuse
one
me,
night the next night. Is this okay. How you treat your women?
Is that Jesus teach you how to do that? Do not
did,
speak.
What, did Jesus get
I'm
married?
Gonna watch.
Did Jesus have wives like that? No, he didn't. Did he treat women like that? No, he did not. Never.
Okay. Can I speak now?
Surah 33. Oh yes, and 33,
excuse
33,
me.
52. No limit on the amount of slave women you can have. Okay, absolutely no limit at all. Didn't Jesus have any slave women at all? No, none.
Okay.
Who would you rather be your moral example?
Prophet Muhammad. So
Muhammad
I have
or
woman.
Jesus,
I was
tell
woman.
Me. Muhammad, do you want him your example today? No, thank you. I would rather have Jesus Christ.
Okay, now we'll go to the verse.
Okay,
the...
who was always,
Lizzie,
always respectful.
Are you sincere
even
to...
the, even the
Lizzie,
women
Lizzie, you're lying against the Quran.
No, no, you tell me, you defend these verses.
Hear the Quran,
sir.
Here, I'm going to the verse.
Yeah, defend them.
Yeah, I'm going to the verse.
Okay,
if you allow me to speak.
Let's
you said something.
Let's hear your defense.
Where's the verse?
Verse
don't
number,
get closer to me.
Yeah.
Just be, because you know. Okay, can I get the first number?
Surah 33, ayah 36
to 38. So you said Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam loved the woman, and remember, the verse doesn't say that.
Okay,
we're gonna read the verse to show you how this woman should get a job in Fox News. Trust me. 36. Okay. But I wanna show you the hypocrisy of this woman, as the Christians always accuse Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam of something. Okay, that's the verse, yeah? 36.
Yeah. Do you have one wife?
Okay, excuse me. No, what are you asking me? Ask me.
According to
why
Islam,
do you have a wife for me?
Yeah, I'm asking you a question.
Why are you asking this question?
You can have more than one wife.
Anyway, it's off subject. Why are you asking this question?
Yeah, I know, because it's embarrassing for you.
Why are you embarrassing?
More than one wife,
no,
But I would be pretty embarrassed by that.
The first, more than one wife. Okay, no problem. The verse, please.
Okay, Surah 33, verse number. Ayah 36 to 38.
Okay, 36.
33, Ayah 36 to 38.
36 doesn't speak about this. 37. أربعة. أخ هي تخرج على الموضوع. نعم. So we go through. Here, look.
Say that.
Okay. Muhammad. So this was a say unto the one to whom God has shown favor and to whom do next English is one. You can read because it's some old English. Okay. Here are the points here. Okay, I'm gonna read it towards. Okay. Muhammad. Did you you did say unto the one to whom God had shown favor and to whom do had shown favor, you shown favor, hold unto your wife, nah? And remain conscious of God, and thus would have hide within himself, within yourself, something God was about to bring to light. Don't show me where he said.
Okay,
no. Quran. Show me where Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said Allah said you want to get married to her.
Right, I'm gonna get my Quran.
I don't trust your Quran. I have Arabic. Anyway,
Lizzie, I'm not laughing.
Lizzie,
we wait.
Go and get a copy. Yeah, we will wait.
Leave him. By the time she comes, yeah, let us read what Moses. Yeah, I want to read about Moses. Now, what God said to him to do. Now, I'm going to ask you to Leviticus to see what God told Moses to do. Because I like the Christian to be consistent. No. Can you read, yeah? She said she can't accept Rasulullah because he fight and all of that. So I'm saying if you don't accept it because he fought, therefore keep your criteria consistent. Reject any prophet that fought. Okay? Bear in mind who sent him to fight is Jesus because you believe Jesus is God. So Jesus sent him to kill innocent people. Now listen to this. When you go out to battle against your enemies and see horses and chariots, yeah? And people more numerous than you, do not be afraid of them. For the Lord your God is with you, who brought you out from Egypt the land. So sure be with your eyes, okay? Let us read. I want to go to this, yeah? And now listen. When you go near a city to fight against it, then proclaim an offer of peace to it. And it shall be that if they accept your offer of peace and open to you, then all the people who are found in it shall be placed under tribute to you and serve you. Now, if the city will not make peace with you, but makes a war against you, then you shall besiege it. And when the Lord your God delivers it into your hand, you should strike every male in it with the edge of the sword. But the women, the little ones, the livestock, and all that is in the city, all it is spoiled. You should plunder for yourselves, and you should eat the enemies. Plunder, which the Lord your God gives to you.
What's the reference?
The reference, Deuteronomy 20, from 10 to 15. So my point here is, Jesus as God, he said to Moses to kill a man, and to take a woman as a slave. She said she can't accept Prophet Muhammad because he did the same thing. So therefore, logically speaking, what she has to reject? She has to reject Moses. Okay? You reject Moses?
Why do you remember Moses again? Okay?
I said she's not getting the point.
When it comes to prophecy, they will turn to Moses.
Okay, okay, you go to Moses.
Right.
Okay.
But anyway, about Muhammad's wife.
I don't trust this translation.
Then there might have been 11. Who knows?
Excuse me, I don't trust this book.
Okay.
You can read it. I don't trust.
It's
not Quran.
This is Quran.
It's Quran. It's English.
Yes.
No, is it English?
Wait, do you trust your Quran?
English one, I don't trust it. Okay, I said Arabic.
You just read to me from the English one.
Yeah, but I read Arabic. So I know what the verse is.
Okay.
You see, that's why Godwin, they cannot play with me.
Yes. Yeah, anyone not trust Arabic. This translation?
Not this one.
Got
the one
good reason
I was from.
To not trust this translation?
Yeah. Because I read Arabic, so I know which one is correct.
Do you trust this
you don't
translation,
like it,
either,
because you don't do safely. Okay. Yeah, I don't like it, because that's Arabic.
Carry on. I think most people here would trust this translation. Yeah?
Carry on.
Okay. And remember when you said to him, Zaid bin Haritha, sorry about my pronunciation.
Zayd ibn Harithah.
Thank you. The freed slave of the Prophet, on whom Allah has bestowed grace by guiding him to Islam, and you, O Muhammad, to have done favor by manumitting him, keep your wife to yourself and fear Allah. But you did hide in yourself, i.e. what Allah has already made known to you, that he will give her to you in marriage, that which Allah will make manifest. You did fear the people, i.e. they're saying that Muhammad married the divorced wife of his manumitted slave. Muhammad was worried about what people
Allah, wait a minute, and a better right
than you should fear him. So when Zayd had accomplished his desire from her, i.e. divorced her, I fear for this woman, we gave her to you in marriage, so that in future there may be no difficulty to the believers in respect of the marriage of their wives of their adopted sons, when the latter have no desire to keep them.
Okay.
Wives, so, you are like
excuse me,
Muhammad was feeling bad about this, so the next surah, which is Surah 33, ayah 38, there is no blame on the Prophet in that which Allah has made legal for him. So it's okay, Muhammad, you don't have to feel bad. You can just go and try to yourself a wife that happens to be the wife of your adopted son.
Excuse me.
And yet this is your example for today. Or is there somebody else who's coming later who's saying this belongs to the 7th century? No.
Okay, now you finished. Yeah. Let's go to the verse. Let us see the verse, yeah? And remember, when you said to him, Zayd ibn Harithah, the freed slave of the Prophet.
No.
I'm about to explain it because the verse refutes you. Yeah. Okay? That shows you that. How do you watch this, yeah? Okay? The freed slave of the Prophet, on whom Allah bestowed grace by guiding him to Islam, and you, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to have done favor by maintaining him. Keep your wife to yourself. What Prophet said to him? Keep your wife to yourself. Yeah? Okay, now carry on. And fear Allah. But you did hide in yourself what Allah has already made.
In other words, he didn't mean it when he says you keep your wife to yourself. Muhammad didn't mean it. Muhammad doesn't keep his word. Why are you following a prophet who doesn't keep his word?
Can you feel me? She's cutting me. Why don't you stop? No, but I keep telling you, she's cutting me.
Carry on.
Okay, anyway.
How many times are you going to read it, though?
Okay, now, listen to this.
Is that your reputation? Can I speak now?
Okay. Now, keep your wife to yourself and fear Allah. But you did hide in yourself what Allah has already made known to you, that He will give her to you in marriage. So Allah, if
what is God like that God allows you to marry whoever you want, even if they're married to somebody else? What is Allah like? I don't like the sound of Allah.
You read it three times.
I've read it three times yet.
Well, you wasn't listening.
The Rashid, subhanAllah.
Are you seeing the film in the camera? Yeah? The hypocrisy.
Anyway,
the hypocrisy. Yeah? So listen. No. So Allah said,
"Can I speak now?"
Nobody's asked my question about the moral character of Allah.
Can I speak now?
Yeah, but I've got loads of questions for you. Finish reading it. I've already read it.
You're gonna be the first victim.
If it's gonna give you some time, you can read it.
Actually, you weren't reading. You were explaining at the same time. So we got confused. Whether you're reading or explaining.
Explaining. Can I speak now? Anyway. So the first speaking that Allah told Prophet Muhammad that Zayd ibn Harithah is gonna get divorced with his wife and she will get married to you. Yes? Why Allah did that? Because
yes,
the Arabs.
Can I speak now?
Because the Arabs were known to them that if you adopt a son, that is from the major sin. If you get married to a woman, then he divorces her to get married to her. And Allah would teach the people that is.
So Muhammad's.
Can I speak now? No.
Muhammad is committing a major sin.
So God telling him, God wants to stop this. God wants to stop this custom, because this custom did not come from God. They made it up. That if you take a son and look after him, and he get married to a woman, then he divorces her, you're not allowed to get married to her.
So Allah wants to finish this custom by telling Prophet Muhammad,
this was happening with Zayd and his wife. In the future, they're going to get divorced. Therefore, when you get divorced and finish the period of time, then you're allowed to get married to her. There's nothing wrong with that.
The Arabs believed, not the Muslims, the Arabs, they heard from their culture
that if someone got married to a woman that he's somewhere he was looking after.
Is Muhammad an Arab?
No.
Is Muhammad an Arab? Arab? Was Muhammad an Arab?
Yeah, Christian,
so
the Arab.
This is right.
Anyway, so
right?
Allah is telling him, oh, Prophet Muhammad, this ruling is not from God. So this ruling to believe, yeah, you know, Allah would to get married to a woman that she was married to someone you took care of, you have to stop that. This has nothing to do with Islam. This is from the pagans. We don't follow the pagans. We follow Allah to us. So the pagan legislation that if you take care of someone and get married to a woman, you should not get married to her. This is not from Islam, and there's nothing wrong with that.
From Islam.
Alhamdulillah.
There's no lasting.
No lasting. There's no lasting there.
It's
she's lied against the Quran.
It's right.
Alhamdulillah.
Here.
It's exposed you.
I've read this surah, and he's completely ignored it.